Hello, this is Musa, Matt Meacham Jr., signing in on Earth. I can't seem to find time to just lay down and just lay back. Every time that I make a decision that I would just lay down, you know, drink me a cappuccino and eat me a couple of chocolate chip cookies, and then just, you know, probably watch a few things on the internet. A chemistry within me, it does something. It's almost uncontrollable. It's all whatever that is happening. It's quite uncontrollable. But I think it has a lot to do with this season that we're in. It must be the season. And because of the season, the elements of the universe will not allow me to rest. The elements of the universe will not allow me to rest, whatever the reason is. Well, I had just had my cappuccino and chocolate chip cookies. I like chocolate chip cookies, and I look for the time of day when I can relax, and I get me a nice cappuccino. I mix it up with coffee, and then I have these big chocolate chip cookies. And then what I do is I dip the chocolate chip cookies into the cappuccino, and that softens the cookie. And then I take a bite out of it. And then after I take a bite out of it, I wash it down with the cappuccino. Now, I think I must confess. I must confess, I have got to start fasting for real. Maybe that's the problem. It's time for me to fast. And until I obey this divine thing, then the angels will not let me rest. That was an attack on a Russian theater just a few hours ago, and he said over 176 Russians were killed at a theater in Russia. And we Americans, don't be foolish. Now, what has happened is the American press says that it was an attack by ISIS. The American press says that it was an attack by ISIS. I remember in one of Donald Trump's hesitations. Donald Trump said that ISIS was a creation of a lady who was married to one of the presidents of the United States, and she was on, she was eventually a cabinet member of one of the presidents. I forget what president, she was a cabinet member, but her last name was Clinton. And she was married to a former president of the United States, Bill Clinton. And I recall that in one of Donald Trump's presentations, he said that ISIS was a creation of Hillary Clinton, an American politician. Donald Trump said that Hillary Clinton and Obama, as I recall, are the inventors of ISIS, the so-called radical group. All you have to do is just search YouTube, I remember distinctly that Mr. Trump said that ISIS was a creation of Hillary Clinton, an American politician who served in one of the cabinets of one of the presidents of the United States several years ago. But just a few hours ago, a theater in Russia, over 170 Russians were killed in a terrorist attack. And what they're trying to say is that it was an attack made by the terrorist group called ISIS. Now, for me to be sitting here thousands of miles from America and just observing the news, I'm just a common, ordinary person. You know, of course, you know, I've written over 200 or 300 books, which are published, and I'm trying out. You should just buy some of my books. I'm a writer. I publish books. That's all I do. But I'm sitting here, and I'm saying, why would ISIS attack Russia? U.S., another warning from one of your brothers, abroad. You better get your act together. And you still keep doing the same thing. You keep putting these black people out front. You keep putting the black people out front. You keep putting the black people out front to do your dirty work. But you know what? It's not going to work. Do you know why? Well, I remember. Okay, I drove taxi cab in several major cities in the U.S. when I was working. You know, I'm a senior citizen now. But when I used to, when I was very young, I drove taxi cab in several major cities in the U.S. And one of those cities that I drove cab in was Los Angeles. I worked in Los Angeles, Beverly Hills, West Hollywood, Santa Monica. I drove cab in those places for about 3 or 4 years when I was very young. And I found it quite interesting. Okay, what I would do, I would go, you know, I would lease my cab. In other words, I would go to a cab owner and I'd say, look, I want to drive your car. And so I would just pay him. You know, I would say, look, I want to lease your car to drive taxi. Of course, you have your license. You have to have your license and everything. But I would always have my own car. I would just lease a cab. And every time I would go and lease a cab from an owner, the owner was a Russian. And every way I would turn in the cab industry, The owners of the camps were Russians. Now, this is in Hollywood, USA, Los Angeles, USA. And another thing that I noticed, I drove cab in Boston, Massachusetts. Okay, Boston, Massachusetts is on the other side of the United States. I drove cab on the Pacific Ocean, at the Pacific Ocean, and I drove cab at the Atlantic Ocean, and I drove cab in the middle. I drove cab in Las Vegas. I drove cab in several cities in the U.S. when I was, you know, a young hustler. I only, when I say hustle, I mean like, you know, somebody, I was a cab driver, okay? And I know there was one time at Logan International Airport, I was sitting in my cab. And what happened was, there was an Ethiopian driver who was in front of me. And then there was a Russian driver behind me. We were parked in the parking space. We were waiting for planes to land. And so all I can remember, it was so many years ago, we talked maybe 30 years ago. All I remember is that the Russian driver, he came up to my cab and something happened. This Russian driver, he hit me upside my head. I said, what? He did this like that. I said, what? I jumped out of my cab and I got all over that guy. I kicked his ass. Yes, I did. This guy, he hits me upside the head. This Russian. I'm not talking about me and the Russian. I have been a tough guy. I was tough. I have gotten into a lot of physical fights. Yes. But what happened is it's not about the fight. It's about the Russian. It's about the Russian in Boston and the Russian in Hollywood. I'm saying, look at these Russians. It's easier for them to get a car, own a cab than me myself, even though I am an American, a black American. We can check that out, a black American. The Russian could come to America, and he could get into business just like that. He could go get him a cab. He could buy him a cab and start his business just like that. But I had to go through a lot of changes if I wanted to own a cab. An American citizen. A black American citizen. So this Russian, white Russian, he's entitled to more than what I'm entitled to. Although, one, he's an alien. But yet, he has more privilege than I did of an American in my own country. Why am I going this way? And where am I going? I'm talking about the degree of racism that exists in the psyche of the American. The degree of racism, that's this thing that's based on skin color, is deep into the fabric of the American culture. Where am I going? I'm talking about this. The war is only minutes away. The war knocks on our door. The war is on its way. And all of these ex-slaves that you white Americans put out front to help you in these trying times. Here we go again. When I look at the news that these black people, Are these black people out front? On the front line. On the front line. You're black Americans. I'm a black American. I'm about as black as a black, I'm about as black as a black American can be. I was born in Alabama. I'm about as black American as any black American. But you black Americans, you guys are being stupid. Why are you letting these white people use you like this? We're getting ready to have a major war right now. And you're going to be on the front line. You, my black American brother, you are going to be on the front line. But you know what you need to do? You need to check out what's behind you. You need to step back and say, why am I out front? Now that it's time to die, now it's time to kill, and now's the time to be killed. Why is this black American? Why are you putting those black guys out front to die for all the sins that you white Anglo-Saxons did to the world? But I guess if these black Americans are so foolish and so stupid and so naive, that they you want to go out, what, prove what? I'm an American. I'm a black American. Where are my loyalties? My loyalty is to God, Almighty God. That's what my loyalty is. Black American, wake up. Because something very serious is about to happen. Something very serious is about to happen. This is Mufa. Matthew Junior. Signing out on Earth.